on this edition of One Championship Weekly. One Championship is kicking off 2019 with a huge show in Jakarta, Indonesia on the 19th of January. A thrilling world title bout takes place as One Strawweight World Champion Joshua Pacio defends his belt for the first time against surging Japanese contender Yosuke Tsuruta. The Filipino phenom will stop at nothing to keep his belt close to his waist. Plus, a featherweight clash with Singapore's Christian Lee and Team Lakai's Edward Kelly. And hometown heroine Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gal sets the stage on fire as she faces India's Pooja Tomar. You're watching One Championship Weekly. On September 2018, Joshua Pacio's lifelong dreams came true when he won the One Strawweight World title in a rematch against Yoshitaka Naito. He hopes to inspire the next generation through martial arts.
I am here with your winner, the new Strawweight World Champion, Joshua the Passion Pacio!
If you are a champion, people will listen to you.
It's all about passion. What were you doing when you were 22 years old? This man's winning world titles and inspiring an entire nation.
At this young age, I proved them that nothing is impossible. I'm gonna use it to inspire the next generation. Not only in these sports, they can become a champion in their own chosen career. As long as you have the dedication, you have the passion to do what you love.
Joshua Pacio also scored high when he pulled off one of the most unique arm locks in One Championship history. He named it the Passion Lock.
Submission of 2018. You know, the more I think about it, I can't go past a particular one. You know, it's not often in this sport you see something different, something new. But in One Championship in 2018, there was a new submission nobody had ever seen before. Nobody had ever thought of, nobody had ever dreamed of, no one had ever concocted something like this, except a young man named Joshua Pacio. Joshua took on Pongsri Mitsatit, fantastic Muay Thai stylist from Thailand.
Pongsri Mitsatit gives up his back and Joshua Pacio jumps on his back like a ninja, has the rear naked choke set up. You can see he starts to lace his arm underneath the neck of Pongsri Mitsatit. Mitsatit keeps his composure but starts to fight the arm, right? But what he does is he leaves his arm open. So he's thinking about the choke and he's not paying attention to the arm. And then you can see Joshua Pacio laces under, grabs the arm. He attacks that arm, pulls the arm with that vice-like grip, pulls it behind him. Now he's got two arms attacking that one arm, cranks it back. He tries to take Pongsri Mitsatit's hand and touch it to the back of his head in one of the most brilliant, creative, innovative submission finishes in all of 2018.
When Mitch Chilson interviews him afterwards, he goes, what was that called? A reverse chicken wing? What was the name of that?
Maybe a passion lock, I think.
He goes, it was called the passion lock. For me, because of its creativeness, its inventiveness, its uniqueness, something we hadn't seen before, and to put it on against an opponent of the highest level as Pongsri Mitsatit, it deserves to be Submission of the Year for 2018. Joshua Pacio and the Passion Lock.
Mitch Chilson, our one commentator, breaks down the Passion Lock.
Joshua Pacio has the back of Pongsri Mitsatit. During this entire position, Joshua Pacio is controlling the left arm of Pongsri Mitsatit by keeping his hand underneath his arm and pinned it close to his chest. From here, he starts to go after the choke. A lot of times, this is used as a distraction to set up the choke, but this time, it was the other way around. As Pongsri Mitsatit started to defend the choke, Joshua Pacio realized that really wasn't what he was after. From there, he pulls the hand out. Now he starts attacking the arm. From here, he goes in, comes underneath with two hands and grabs the wrist. From here, he pulls the arm behind the back of Pong's three mitsati. Here, he takes his other hand and comes underneath the hand of Pong's three mitsati. Starts cranking on the arm, trying to touch the hand to the back of his head in a very unique submission for the first time ever, calling it the Passion Lock.
When we return, we take a look at Pacio's victory moment when he won the one strawweight world title belt. You're watching ONE Championship Weekly. Welcome back to ONE Championship Weekly. We relive the emotional moment when Joshua Pacio claimed the one strawweight world title belt against Japanese sensation Yoshitaka Naito. Let's join the action in the last round.
We are going to go into the fifth and final round of the main event here in Jakarta for the World Strawweight Championship. There's the champion, Yoshitaka Naito. Everybody here in Jakarta on the edge of their seats. We've got ourselves a sellout. And already you see a little more pepper, a little more mustard out of Yoshitaka Naito. There's a certain gusto about the champion now. A high kick from Pacio. Nobita working angles, those awkward angles, the little quarter turns, the little pirouettes. It's the fifth round of our world title main event. Mixed martial arts global rule set in action. Outside leg kick from Pacio. Nobita in center cage. Pacio tried to scoop the right hand. Will the gold go back to Japan? Will it go to the Philippines?
Yeah, we're pretty close either way, but we're starting to see Naito definitely has a little bit more urgency behind a lot of these engagements. You know, he's starting to push forward, and Pacio's slowing down just a little bit. And just as I said that, he lands a big knee. Look at the sacrifice. What he does is he pulls guard into the half guard, and now he's able to get control of the hips. Let's see if he can reverse him.
Top position here for Pacio. Could he find a sub from this position? The 22-year-old from Baguio City in the Philippines goes onto his back here. Top position now for Nobita.
Great reversal there from Naito. He was able to get that single leg, transition out, get back on top. This is a bad spot for Pacio to be in.
So what are the options for the champion here, Mitch?
Well, you can probably wait a little bit. Oh, look at that, look at it. Beautifully done, minor mistake. He was trying to pass the half guard into mount. And Pacio is able to slide out, end up on top, and get out.
Nobita wants Pacio on the canvas. There he goes now. Pacio trying to sink some sort of choke attempt. Nobita looking to pass the guard, goes there. Well done from the champion. What's Nobita looking for here, Mitch?
You can see Joshua is trying to get the legs around one of the legs. So he's trying to catch a leg to get back into half. And that was the battle right there. But Naito looks to be winning it right there on the right leg. Pacio's trying to get back into the half guard, but good job by Naito to nullify that.
Once again, Yoshitaka Naito has been to the fifth round now 5 times in his career. This is very familiar territory. Pacio before tonight had never been past a third round. This is usually where Naito is so strong, where he usually powers up, where he usually owns opponents in the fifth, the final, the championship round.
Good scrambles by Pacio, but I think he gave up the mount. He's back in half guard. Yup, he's back in half guard, but look at the way Naito is able to float around, almost back into side control, but good job by Pacio to pull him back into guard to stop the advancing of position from Naito, but he hops over. Now he's back into a possible side control, but a good sweep there from Pacio.
Pacio hunting after the left arm of Nobita. Can he find something here? The passion, the passion. Can he take home that arm? If he takes it home, he'll take home the gold as well. But no, Nobita seems to be okay.
Yeah, that's kind of what's gonna be really hard. All he can do to use this Kimura for is a sweep to control the position.
What to finish?
Naito might try to roll the other way. That he does, and he gets up, he continually attacks the leg.
The high IQ of the champion gets him out of that predicament. And now Nobita looking to take it to ground. They go there. What does Pacio do from here, Mitch?
Well, he's trying to push the his head away to create a little bit of space and not give up side control. Naito looks to be getting pretty close to it. Yep, now he's got side control. Good advance on the position from Naito. Pacio's going to scramble, though, try to get out. And that he does. Attacks the leg.
Back up onto their feet. Final minute, fifth and final round. Drops down to take the legs from under Pacio. Pacio trying to maintain his vertical base. What a thrilling, gripping final round of action. Indeed, this entire World Championship main event has been extraordinary. 40 seconds on the clock now, Mitch.
Look at that back and forth action from both these guys. Naito is continually trying to pass the guard, but look at Pacio, able to keep the guard in place and battle for the last 20 seconds.
20 seconds on the clock. Naito has Pacio's back. What's going to happen here for the champion? Can he sink a choke in the final seconds? Pacio defends. This one's going to go down to the wire. I'd hate to be a judge. It's so close. It's razor thin. Is he going to finish on top of the champion? Yes, it looks like it. What a contest between two superb martial artists at the height of their powers. My word, that was phenomenal. And look at the respect, and look at the replay.
There was a little bit of a light touch on the leg kick, but Pacio was able to counter with a leg kick of his own, add a big left hook to punctuate that exchange. Here's Naito continually scrambling, always looking for something, always trying to move forward, has that ground control. Look at this, he's able to end up on top in the exchange, goes after the leg again, and I think he was able to secure the takedown there at the end of that grappling scramble. But man, what back and forth action. I have got to say, I am extremely impressed, win or lose, with Pacio's improvement in the grappling.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision, and new world strawweight world champion, Joshua Pacio!
It's a new world champion! It's a Filipino world champion! The passion, Joshua Pacio claims gold at 22 years old! What a moment! Joshua Pacio, out-thinking, out-strategizing, out-working Yoshitaka Naito. A rain of gold here in Jakarta, and the gold goes back to Baguio City. It's Filipino gold, it's Team Lakai gold, it's Joshua Pacio gold. Emotional scenes here in Jakarta. Gold all over the cage, and gold over the shoulder of Joshua Pacio.
When we return, Priscilla Hurtado Lumbongal shares the responsibility she has to set an example for her fellow compatriots to follow. You're watching One Championship Weekly. Welcome back to One Championship Weekly. Every time Priscilla Hurtado Lumbongal steps into the cage, she'll not only be looking for a victory to advance her world championship ambitions, but also to inspire a nation.
Saya mencoba menjadi panutan di mata masyarakat Indonesia dengan cara menunjukkan prestasi saya, dan saya berusaha menunjukkan prestasi itu dengan cara berlatih giat, karena tanpa berlatih saya tidak bisa seperti sekarang ini. Seorang juara itu ketika dia juara tapi dia tidak berlatih itu hanya sementara, tapi seorang juara yang sesungguhnya itu bisa mempertahankan prestasinya dengan menunjukkan seberapa kuat dia bertahan, seberapa kuat dia berlatih dan mendisiplinkan dirinya. Rasanya pasti senangnya karena mereka datang khusus menonton kita ketika kita di arena pertandingan itu hanya untuk mensupport kita. Saya berusaha untuk memberi kepuasan kepada mereka dengan menunjukkan permainan terbaik saya ketika saya berada di dalam cage. Bangga ya bisa berdiri di podium itu dengan membawa nama Indonesia, karena tidak banyak orang yang bisa seperti itu dengan bisa memberikan prestasi kali ya, itu yang menjadi panutan bagi orang lain.
While our athletes may seem fearless in the cage, can they fearlessly handle these 10 questions?
Aungla Ensang. Doraemon. Badminton. Dok. Medan. Dolok Sanggul. Mie, segala jenis mie. Teks. Hamburger. Menaiki bukit. Menulis puisi. Ya, waktu zaman saya sekolah, saya suka tulis-tulis puisi.
Another athlete competing in Jakarta is Singapore's Christian the Warrior Lee. There is only one thing on his mind. A chance at the world title again.
Christian the Warrior
My goal is to be the best martial artist in the world. I feel that I will work my way up the rankings and I will eventually get that featherweight belt. You know, whether it's with Martin or with someone else, you know, it's gonna be mine. The first bout with Martin was early in my career and he was the better man that night. The second fight we had in Singapore was a very close contest. Definitely helped me to learn a lot about myself as a fighter, as a martial artist, as a person. I know that I can dig deeper. I know that if we fight again, I will finish him. I've been following Edward Kelly's career for quite some time now. We fought together on the same card before, and I know he's a tough fighter. He's got a good kill instinct. He's got good striking, good takedown defense. But overall, his game won't be enough to stop me. I am better in every area, and I will finish him in the first round.
We take a look at Christian Lee's recent win against Japanese Kazuki Tokudome.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next match is 3 rounds of 5 minutes in a one championship catchweight contest. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, he is the Pancrase lightweight world champion, standing at 180 centimeters tall, holding a mixed martial arts record of 18 wins and 9 losses. Training out of Paraistra Hachioji, representing Japan, presenting to you, Kazuki Tokudome. And now, introducing his opponent out of the red corner, he is a 6-time Pancration world champion, standing at 180 centimeters tall, holding a mixed martial arts record of 9 wins and 3 losses. Training out of Evolve MMA and United MMA, representing Singapore! Put your hands together for Christian the Warrior Lee!
Three rounds at a catchweight of 73 kilos. Christian Lee, Singapore. Ready. Kazuki Tokudome, Japan. Inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium. And Christian Lee in the white trunks bounds out of his corner. A cutting side kick early to the lead knee. We're back under our global rule set, mixed martial arts. Quick hands from Christian Lee, gets a takedown.
Nice entry into that takedown. Hit that straight right hand right into a double leg. But look at the judo black belt getting thrown on his butt right there.
Ultra aggressive start here from young Christian Lee. 9 wins, 5 KOs, 4 submissions, 100% finishing rate.
An interesting clinch battle we got going on here. Tokudome got him up, puts him down.
Nicely done there from Tokudome. The lightweight king of pancrase, 19 wins, 9 knockouts, 2 submissions. Second degree black belt in judo, BJJ purple belt. Holds a degree in judo therapy from the Nippon Engineering College of Hachioji.
Christian Lee's got that defensive guard right there. Now Tokudome tried to step over. Now he's in the half guard of Christian Lee. Tapping the back of the head there. That's not legal. Tokudome does a good job of pressing him up against the cage. Christian Lee's going to try to walk out. He's created a little bit of space off that cage.
Tokudome predicted he'd knock out Christian Lee with punches. Lee said, I'll submit him in the very first round. Back to their feet here. Singaporean crowd right behind Christian Lee. In his corner, his father Ken Lee, his sister, Adam Waite world champion, undefeated, unstoppable Angela Lee. Nice corking outside thigh knees there from Tokudome.
I know Martin Nguyen is paying very close attention to this one. He's in the crowd sitting front row right there. He's got his eye on both these two as possible competitors. He's gone up against Christian Lee before, and a rematch has been in the works if Christian Lee can get past Tokudome on this one.
Side kick there from Lee. BJJ black belt, 8-week training camp. Said he refined every piece of his game, tightened up everything, says he's faster and has the advantage everywhere. High lift roundhouse kick in the wash again. Oh, right hand! Smack bang on the kisser from Christian Lee.
Oh, right into the entry into the double leg. Tokudome's got to be careful of that trip right there. Good defense. Might give up his back. Good scramble from Tokudome.
Tokudome said his strategy is to keep the match standing for as long as he can. Though he did expect Christian Lee to try and take him down. Southpaw stance here for Tokudome. There's that right hand. Smack bang again to the kisser. And the hammer fist strikes from Christian Lee. The aggression now from the youngster. The reverse elbows from Lee. And he's in full mount now. Tokudome gives his back. The hooks go in. It's trouble for the Japanese. Christian Lee. A house on fire. Tokudome. The most finishes in one championship, the 100% finishing rate, the human highlight reel, and Martin Nguyen gives him a standing ovation.
Wow, look at this. That right hand would have dropped him, but Christian Lee went right into it and just absolutely swarmed all over. Tokudome gets the mount, drops the elbows, and just doesn't even go for the toe, just punches his way from that rear. Once he has the back mount, just starts to unload on him. Look at this, Michael, just uncorking these shots all over Tokudome. So impressive from Christian Lee.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kim Cheng, has called a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 7 seconds in the first round. For your winner, by way of technical knockout, Christian Lee!
Another highlight reel finish from 20-year-old Christian Lee. He brought the aggression early. He never relented until the job was done.
One Championship is set to be even bigger and better in 2019. We kick off in Jakarta, Indonesia on the 19th of January with an electrifying world title bout topping its bill. One strawweight world champion Joshua Pacio puts his belt on the line in his first defense against Japanese contender Yosuke Tsuruta. On the 25th of January, ONE is set to ignite the Mall of Asia Arena in Manila. February features two iconic Asian cities, in Bangkok on the 16th of February and in Singapore on the 22nd of February. On the 8th of March, we return to Yangon, Myanmar. And history will be made on the 31st of March as ONE ushers in a new era of martial arts in Japan with its inaugural show in Tokyo. With three world championship bouts, ONE, a new era, is the biggest event in ONE history you don't want to miss. Check your local listings. Thank you for watching ONE Championship Weekly. Press the red button to subscribe.